Oyster is a Muslim monopoly. There have been more details. And now today, the Islam is called as an intolerant religion. And we normally, again, apologize. No, no, Islam. I tell the people, Islam is an intolerant religion. It is intolerant towards injustice. It's intolerant towards discrimination. It's intolerant towards racism. It's intolerant towards victimization. It is an intolerant religion. It is intolerant to things which they feel is right and we feel is wrong. We feel injustice is wrong. Therefore, we are intolerant towards it. We feel victimization is wrong. We feel racism is wrong. We feel discrimination is wrong. Islam is intolerance towards the things which they feel is right and we feel is wrong. And furthermore, many things which the Western world feels is right for society, we feel is wrong. So we are intolerant towards alcoholism. We are intolerant towards drug addiction. We are intolerant towards pornography, towards prostitution, towards adultery. Islam is an intolerant religion. It's intolerant to those things which are harmful to humanity. That's the reason I say Islam is the solution for humanity. Just because they want to enjoy life, they make it normal. Alcoholism, no problem. Prostitution, no problem. Drug addiction, no problem. They want to earn money, because of a selected few who want to rule the world, they are putting things into society and saying it is normal, which Islam is intolerant to things which are harmful to humanity. It is an intolerant religion. But to things which are good for society, not only is it tolerant, it emphasizes it's a must. You should be just, you should be honest, you should be loving, you should be kind. And Islam, besides speaking about good things, it shows you a way how to achieve that goodness. See, if you go to any country in the world, or any religion, all the religions say that robbing is bad. Hinduism says robbing is bad, Christianity says robbing is bad, Judaism says Islam says this. All the countries in the world, whether it be America, whether it be Pakistan, whether it be India, whether it be Italy, all the countries are robbing is bad. But Islam shows you a way how to achieve a state in which people will not rob. It gives you the solution, not only theory, practically. Islam has a system of zakat. That is, every rich person who has a saving of more than the nisab level, more than 85 grams of gold, he or she should give 2.5% of that excess wealth every lunar year in charity. If every rich human being gives charity, all people will be eradicated from this world. There will not be a single human being who dies. I am requesting the organizers to increase the volume, because I am straining my vocal cords. I request the organizers, unless I'm not firm, they don't listen. I don't know why. Yes, please, thank you. See, a non-Muslim is understanding better. Therefore, Quran says, yesterday I told you, stop in Gaimun Gairakum, summa alaik in amsalakum. If you don't do your job, Allah will stop you in your place, and other people, and they will not be like you. Allah doesn't require you and me. If you don't listen to Allah's kalam, Allah will change in our place another people and they will not be like you and me. And that's what we're seeing. Islam is spreading. Which I say in the end of my talk. In the end of my talk, I'll say how Islam is spreading. Allah doesn't require you and me, the rubbish that we are. We aren't following his kalam. Here we analyze that Islam, besides telling you not to rob, it shows you a state rich people will not rob. Every rich human being should give zakat, 2.5% of his excess wealth, every human charity. If every human being gives zakat, poverty will be eradicated from this world, there will not be a single human being who will die from them. After that, the Quran says in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 38, as to the thief, be it a man or a woman, chop off his or her hand as a solution. MashaAllah, Jazakallah, sister. May Allah reward you. See, now Now again,